I'm Victoria Hunt, and I am an extreme cheapskate. Okay, this is my bedroom. I'll be the first to admit that it's kind of ugly. This blind came with the house. Free. That's the best price of all. So this is my bathtub. Look, it's brand new and shiny. I don't even have to clean it. There's no mildew on my grout, which is amazing. I have never cleaned it because I've never used it. I have a gym membership, and that's where I take my shower. I like to work out. I'm kind of a gym rat. I'm there every day anyway. This is where I deposit my urine. In an effort to save money, I started peeing in a jar. Just coincidentally happens to be in a lemonade jar. Quite pungent. And the longer it sits, the stronger it gets. I had read online that you can put your urine into your compost pile. And I thought, wow, I can pee in a jar, build my compost, and not have to flush my toilet. My water bill went from $30 a month to $20 a month. So there's $10 right there. So I pee in a bottle, but don't get me wrong. I poop like everybody else, and I put that in the toilet. And so I flush probably one or two times a day. This house was built in 1961. I get a really good deal. The appliances are all 1961. So this is my kitchen. This is the original 1961 oven. I eat a lot of eggs because I have chickens. And so I use this to cook my eggs pretty much every day. So I use my stove pretty regularly. All the burners work. It's kind of hideous looking, but I really don't care. Everything here works. Well, maybe. This cheap side of me has like really blossomed because every minute of every day has something to do with how I can make a better decision financially. It's a little bit of an obsession. As you can see, I have a very nice television, but I don't plug it in. I keep everything unplugged unless I'm using something. I put my freezer on this timer mechanism, on for 12 hours, off for 12 hours. I'm saving 50% on my electric bill. I think some people are a little squeamish about it. Well, what about the meat? It might like get a little thaw and freeze. I've never seen it happen. Every morning I come out here, this is the electric meter. 10,297. My meter reads 10,297, so I need to go and put that in my spreadsheet. I've had the spreadsheet since 1989. I have all of my expenses, food, electric, the heating bill, fun money, birthday presents, Christmas, you name it, I've got it covered. I don't have a paycheck coming in every day, so I need to make sure that my income exceeds my expenses. So I set up this spreadsheet to budget my entire life, and it goes all the way out to age 116, which is a number that like came to me in a dream or something. I'm convinced that I'm gonna live to be 116 years old. I'm only 50 right now. I haven't even lived half my life. Steve and I, we've been dating about a year. We're at the point in our relationship where we really want to come together and we want to share our lives.
And now we're going to do the trial move-in. My lifestyle's a little bit different than Victoria's. And she's a little offbeat, a little eclectic, kind of a marches to her own drummer. And I really like that.
All right, here I am. Here's really? My luggage and here's me.
Is that it?
No.
Oh boy.
As I got to know her better, I came to find out she's a little too cheap. Victoria is the only millionaire that I know that dumpster dives.
A lot of the things that I do are extreme. But you know what? I absolutely get results.
Victoria and I had been dating for a while, and I had been coming to her home, and I went into the bathroom, and I noticed a bottle sitting on the floor. And I wasn't quite sure what it was, so I used the restroom, and I went out, and I asked her, "What's that bottle on the floor next to your toilet?" And she said, "Oh, I pee in a bottle." And I'm like, "You do?"
Yeah.
Our trial run might be hit or miss. I'm hesitant about living together. To be honest with you, I've never put another person in my budget.
Right.
I'm a little skeptical, but I'm just gonna go full steam ahead and see how it goes.
How much money do you spend on food a month?
$200 or something.
Really?
Okay, $500. I don't know.
I think.
I don't know.
Do you have more stuff?
My microwave?
Oh, see.
A much newer one.
I'm bringing items I knew I had to be happy. All my chargers for my electrical items, simple day-to-day things that I'd expect to be there.
Oh, this would be good over here to plug in all my chargers.
Wow, what the hell is all of that?
My drill, where can I plug this in?
I don't care.
I don't know if Steve's trying to see how far he can push me. He shows up with all of these electric appliances.
All right, well, we're gonna have to sit down and figure this out.
Right.
I kind of panicked.
I'm trying to figure out, like, what kilowatts, but I don't know how to figure that out.
So what's that gonna tell you?
Come on, you know me, and I gotta do the numbers. If you were gonna...
Do a spreadsheet.
If you were, I will. You know, I should make you do the math.
I don't know.
Hold on. I love you.
And I love you.
Listen, I want you to just try to see things from my point of view. And so your job is to figure out how much it costs to cook a frozen dinner in this microwave.
Oh my goodness.
I'm not entirely sure how this trial live-in is going.
Seriously?
I'm a hard nut to crack. So when Steve gets settled in here, I think he's in for a surprise.
All right, so I'm putting in that you moved in yesterday. Hello, you listening?
Yeah.
You've been here one day. If I extrapolate on a monthly basis, my water bill has gone up 30%.
You know that in one day?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So I wanna see, I need you to start peeing in a bottle for me. Please?
No.